The difference between a good logo and a great logo often lies in the details. After looking at the logo art from the previous tutorial, we realized we need to make some minor adjustments based on feedback. So let's look at how some minor tweaks can turn a good logo into a great logo. In this tutorial, you'll start by applying finishing touches to parts of the logo to get it just right. Then you'll apply a brand color palette to make sure it has the look and feel you need. First, before you start the tutorial, let's explore some examples. Let's start by finishing the body of the bee. I sent the initial logo art to reviewers, and everyone that reviewed it felt that there needs to be a connecting line here. Instead of creating a new line, you can just copy and paste the one that's there. It then needs to be rotated to fit in place. So let's use the rotate tool. This tool allows us to rotate objects around their center or any point. In this case, we'll rotate it around the leftmost point so the lines are still connected to make the body look more complete. Up to this point, you've applied color and created shapes, but where Illustrator's power really stands out is in how much you can do with things like color and shapes. For example, if you have a fill applied to a shape and you need it to be a stroke instead, you could add a stroke color to the shape and then remove the fill color. But because Illustrator comes with so many options, you can just swap the fill so it becomes the stroke color and make the stroke as big as you need in the properties panel. Alone, these small features might not seem impactful, but when you spend a lot of time on a project, these small features translate to more control, which means more creative power for you. In the first tutorial in this series, you designed your logo art in black and white. This helped you work out the logo's details and make it look good in all sizes and on every medium. Once we've finalized our adjustments, let's apply the brand colors now from the Bibli brand. When we say apply brand colors, it's not just applying color to shapes. Because it's a logo, it's more than that. Brand colors are the consistent set of colors that a company or even individual uses to represent their personality and style on social media, on packaging, everywhere. When you click either the fill or stroke icons in the properties panel with something selected, the swatches panel pops up. Here you can click any of these default colors to replace the original black color. You notice the folder in the panel? You can save and group colors for your brand and apply them to different parts of your logo. So let's recap. You saw how to rotate, resize, and align some parts of your design, and you personalized the logo with your brand colors. Now it's your turn. Start this tutorial with step-by-step instructions to finish your black and white logo and make it pop with colors.